وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد And inshallah ta'ala in this episode I'm going to inshallah ta'ala point out and discuss بإذن الله الكريم the heading الصيام عبادة وليس عادة that the fasting is an act of worship And it's not a norms. I want us to all understand this point. This is very important. Many Muslims around the world believe fasting is a cultural thing. They believe this is a cultural thing. We've been doing this for decades and centuries, and this is part of our culture. So you tend to find people who are not practicing the religion will be fasting this month. All because it's the culture and it's the norms of his people. What we really have to understand is fasting isn't a ada. It's not a cultural thing. It's an act of worship. It's a farida. It's an obligatory act. And if we don't feel this, that it's an act of worship, it will mess up our intentions and we won't get rewarded for it. The person has to intend this act as a worship. If you do an act as a norms, there is no reward for you. And this is missed by many people. The scholars, they talk about the concept of qasd. Qasd means to intend something. It's to intend to do something. To have an intention of something. The scholars, they divide the qasd into two. The qasd, they divide it into two. They say, قصد المعبود and the second one is قصد العبادة قصد المعبود means who are you doing this action for? Who are you doing this action for? And that's the one that the scholars refer to as ikhlas and that's not what we're talking about now. The second type of قصد is قصد العبادة that you intend to do an عبادة يعني what you're intending is not a norms. You're intending an ibadah. And this happens in two ways. To distinguish one ibadah from another ibadah, or to distinguish a ibadah from a norms, a custom of a people. To distinguish one ibadah from another ibadah, for example, might be distinguishing the fasting of Ramadan from fasting Mondays and Thursdays. You have to distinguish the intention. So that's distinguishing one ibadah from another ibadah. Distinguishing a norms from a ibadah, for example, maybe someone who loves to shower every morning. He just loves to shower every morning. Okay? Now, he wakes up one morning and there is a janaba, major impurity that happened to him. He now has to distinguish with his intention. Is this going to be the normal shower I used to have every morning? Or is this going to be the ghusl, a shar'i, that the sharia legislated, which is an act of worship? Am I going to do it as an act of worship? Or am I going to do it as my norms? This is distinguishing an ibadah from an adah. We have to, as Muslims, know that fasting is an ibadah, and that's the intention that we need to come with. And that's why when you look at the hadith al-Qudsi, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, يَتْرُكُ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ وَشَهْوَتَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي He leaves off eating, and He also leaves off drinking, and He also leaves off sexual intercourse for my sake. So you're leaving off eating and drinking, and you leave off sexually fulfilling yourself all because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. min ajli. And that's what we want to understand, that you're doing it as an act of worship. ولذلك عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, ليس الصيام من الطعام والشراب وحده. That fasting is not just to be fasting from and to abstain from drinking and eating. That's not what it is only. ولكنه من الكذب والباطل واللغو والحلف. But rather it is to abstain from lying, falsehood, idle speech, swearing. And you stay away from all of that. ليس الصيام من الطعام والشراب وحده ولكنه من الكذب والباطل واللغو والحلف. So many people, all they know about fasting is don't eat food, don't drink, don't have sexual intercourse. But they lie, they cheat, they deceive, idle speech. وما إلى ذلك. This is a person who hasn't understood fasting. Fasting is more than staying away from food and drinking. Rather, Maymun ibn Mihran, he said, أهون الصيام الصيام عن الطعام. The easiest form of fasting is to actually fast from food. That's the easiest form of fasting. يعني to stay away from food is the easiest one. It's harder to stay away from lying, cheating and deceiving and desires and holding yourself back and refraining from any things that the Sharia has prohibited you from. That's the hardest form. So fasting is an act of worship. You're in an ibadah every moment you're fasting. وَلِذَلِكَ the reward for the person and to receive this reward, يعني to be forgiven for your past sins, you have to be doing it as a faith, as an iman, not an adah. It can't be a norms. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, al-imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated min hadith Abi Huraira, man sama ramadan imanan wa ihtisaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Anyone who fasts Ramadan with two things, imanan, faith, wa ihtisaban, hoping reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then and only then does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you for your past sins. Ponder here. Your fasting is done based on iman. You're doing this for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tasdeeq. You believe in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one is you're hoping reward from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. With those two, your sins will be forgiven. You can't just be doing it because everybody in the local area is doing it. If I don't do it, everyone else is going to look at me in a bad way. No. You have to come with an intention. And we, as Muslims, many of us don't understand the value and the importance of a good intention. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, he said, رُبَّ عَمَلٍ صَغِيرٍ تُعَظِّمْهُ النِّيَّةِ وَرُبَّ عَمَلٍ كَبِيرٍ تُصَغِّرْهُ النِّيَّةِ. Maybe a small action that you did, what magnifies it is an intention that you came with it. يعني the action is very little, but what made this big is an intention you came with. The intention magnified it. وَرُبَّ عَمَلٍ كَبِيرٍ. And sometimes you could be doing a big action, a lot of actions. تُصَغِيرُهُ النِّيَّةُ. The intention lessens it and reduces it. It gets reduced only because of your intention. So we have to understand where and how far the intention can reach. Just sitting down and thinking and having that intention that you're an act of worship, it can change everything. And the fact that you just believe this is a cultural thing, my people and we've been doing this all our lives. I'm going to do that with my family and we're going to do it as a collective thing. You don't get anything from it and you lose out. And a person, subhanAllah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala allows them to reach somewhere far, all because of their intention. Muhammad ibn al-Husayn, he said, يَنْبَغِي لِلْرَجُلِ أَن تَكُونَ نِيَتُهُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ عَمَلِهِ. He said, rahimahullah, it is required from a man or a woman that their intention surpasses their action. Yani, your intention goes beyond and above your actions. Think of something deeply before you even engage in it. Have an intention set prior to you engaging in that particular action, so you can get rewarded greatly. Thabit al-Bunani, he said, نِيَّةُ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَبْلَغُ مِنْ عَمَلِهِ, that the person's intention is far than the person's actions. The person's intention goes beyond and above his actions. And we know a group of people who may not be able to do an action with us, but because they had the intention, they reach us in that reward. The Prophet told us in many ahadiths, when he said to the companions, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ لَرِجَالًا, in Medina there are men. مَا سِرْتُمْ مَسِيرَةً وَلَا قَطَعْتُمْ وَادِيَةً, you guys have not moved the distance. You have not cut a valley. إِلَّا كَانُوا مَعَكُمْ, except that they are with you in reward. In Medina there are some of your brothers. They are not here with you right now. They are not cutting the distance. They are not going under the valleys. They are not going through the hardships that you guys are going through. But they are participating with you in reward. I mean, how? They're in Medina, they're not with us. And this is the Battle of Tabuk. Sahabas, they walked 1,400 kilometers taqriban. And they're told that there are people in Medina who are not doing anything, but they have the same reward as them. How? The reason is because their intention, they wanted to be with their brothers. They wanted to be walking with them. They wanted to participate in the battle with them. Like, what happened to them? حَبَسَهُمُ الْمَرَضِ, what imprisoned them and prevented them from doing is sickness and illness. They had the intention. Their intention reached far than that which their actions couldn't reach. So it's important that the month of Ramadan is coming. We set our priorities straight. We know why we are doing it and who we are doing it for. We're not doing it because it's a time to socialize with our cousins and our relatives and to break iftar with them. Those are other things. The real core reason for is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Jannah we want, and we want us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He distanced us from the hellfire. We are doing it because it's an act of worship that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala prescribed upon us and ordained upon us that we must do. I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala for today's episode. Anything that I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, a shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.